As night turns to dimness and draws back its curtain, stars, those bright sequins, now all disappear. As dimness grows radiant, dawn makes it certain that butterfly weather, quite perfect, is here. Thundery cumulus masses are drifting very far off. Overhead, very high, cirrus clouds spread their pink feathers, then lifting, dissolve, and are lost in the turquoise blue sky. Up comes the sun, and the very long shadows grow shorter. His light is like amber, the glow where gray mists have melted away from the meadows, starts dewdrops all sparkling like jewels below. Creatures that fly or that creep, hop or run, now wake all at once at a loud trumpet call to tell them this greatest of days has begun, the day of the feast and the butterfly ball. At the sound of the trumpet, the dozens invited now jump out of bed, squealing, "This is the day! Oh, goody, the ball! Aren't you really madly excited? Get up and get ready. Let's be on our way."
Thank you. There's a ball. Should we be there? It seems to me, I think we ought to be with someone somewhere. So pardon me, brother. Give us another. Excuse me. It's good to be together again. Starts to swim. I can't stand these players, number six. I had a lot of fun, and now it's begun. Between and betwixt. So pardon me, brother. Fred, if I ask you for another, don't think I'm complaining. It's good to be together again. All right. Together again.
Oh, blind mole, he never thought that sweet home down in his old, old line low. He don't need me, are you? Old line low. He don't need gasoline or coal. Old line low. He don't need me, are you?
Dark on earth, dusky, misty, ghostly, it's then magician moth goes flitting mostly, softer than a breath. Marked with a skull since birth, he knows no fear of death, and when he folds his patterned velvet wings, keeps very still. As midnight darkens, keeps very still, and hearkens to the faintest, strangest, and most secret things. They say that whispers from some very far, never seen, and nameless star give him power to foresee happenings unknown. Before the ball was even thought of, he knew just when it would be. So here he is, in the clear light of day, famous magician Morph, outside this place of call, the busy old white lion, buying a jug of honey, something to rely on, before he flits away, but not till after sunset.
How are you? All right? Sorry about this.
It's not so funny what that smile bless you.
Could those creatures that slither and crawl ever have got to the butterfly ball? All had been asked and wanted to go, but snails are so sluggish and slugs are so slow. How could they have got to the ball? We'll put on an airlift, I think it's our duty, and ferry them there, said the Camberwell beauty. We'll fly through the sky in this festival weather, a seven in hand all harnessed together, and we can bring them to the ball. So swallowtail, orange tip, peacock and brimstone, purple emperor, little chalk blue, brighter than flags of the quarreling nations, happily fluttered and peacefully flew and ferried the snails to the ball. afternoon, Froggy went a-wooing far where the clear-cut hilltops are, idly touching his guitar. Noticed Badger drifting by, Badger in his striped balloon. To the ball go drifting by, not too low and not too high, through the dreamy afternoon. Where the clear-cut hilltops are reflected in the glassy lake, Froggy plucked at his guitar through the dreamy afternoon. Ditties drifting on the wind, fingers picking out the tune, never making a mistake. Fox was fishing with a friend, and they listened by the lake. Out of wooing, but having sung and having played and found that there was nothing doing, comfortably down he laid both himself and his guitar, where the spotted agarics are. On the pillow dreaming, he saw uprising, circling, see persons known.
times affect us all. Whether you hop or fly or crawl, don't drink the water.
Beginning. From every direction, guests are all crowding to join in the fun. Was ever there seen such a varied collection of beautiful creatures? The ball has begun. First the damselfly's ballet, so nimble on tiptoe, with glittering wings, and so famous, these four, they can kick in a can-can or dance a calypso, and whatever they do always gets an encore. When Rabbit and Fox put on different faces, you can't be quite certain whichever they are, but soon all the guests will be showing their paces to the loud hurdy-gurdy and Froggy's guitar. They'll see Aranea on gossamer prancing over Harlequin Hair with his one-hair band, and happy-go-lucky Grasshopper dancing with lovely winged butterflies hand in hand. With slugs, mice, squirrels, and all sorts of creatures, ants, moths, and earwigs, the place will be packed. Some will say, whose are those faces and features? And all will be happy as act follows act. Each one will feel that this great ball is bringing the joy of a lifetime. And all are agreed with Froggy, who twangs his guitar, sweetly singing his favorite song that says, love's all you need.
All we need is
Quite perfect is here. Thundery cumulus masses are drifting very far off. Overhead, very high, cirrus clouds spread their pink feathers, then lifting, dissolve and are lost in the turquoise blue sky. Up comes the sun. And the very long shadows grow shorter. His light is like amber. The glow where gray mists have melted away from the meadows starts dewdrops all sparkling like jewels below. Creatures that fly or that creep, hop or run, now wake all at once at a loud trumpet call to tell them this greatest of days has begun, the day of the feast and the butterfly ball. At the sound of the trumpet, the dozens invited now jump out of bed, squealing, "This is the day! Oh, goody, the ball! Aren't you really madly excited? Get up and get ready. Let's be on our way." Thank you. Dusky, misty, ghostly, it's then magician moth goes flitting mostly, softer than a breath. Marked with a skull since birth, he knows no fear of death. And when he folds his patterned velvet wings, keeps very still as midnight darkens, keeps very still. Hearkens to the faintest, strangest, and most... one hair band, and happy-go-lucky grasshopper dancing with lovely winged butterflies hand in hand, with slugs, mice, squirrels, and all sorts of creatures, ants, moths, and earwigs, the place will be packed. Some will say, whose are those faces and features? And all will be happy as act follows act. Each one will feel that this great ball is bringing the joy of a lifetime. And all are agreed with Froggy, who twangs his guitar, sweetly singing his favorite song that says, love's all you need. Could those creatures that slither and crawl ever have got to the butterfly ball? All had been asked and wanted to go, but snails are so sluggish and slugs are so slow. How could they have got to the ball? We'll put on an airlift, I think it's our duty, and ferry them there, said the Camberwell beauty. We'll fly through the sky in this festival weather, a seven in hand all harnessed together, and we can bring them to the ball. So swallowtail, orange tip, peacock and brimstone, purple emperor, little chalk blue, brighter than flags of the quarreling nations, happily fluttered and peacefully flew and ferried the snails to the ball. Thank you. a seven in hand, all harnessed together, and we can bring them to the ball. So Swallowtail, Orange Tip, Peacock and Brimstone, Purple Emperor, Little Chalk Blue, brighter than flags of the quarreling nations, happily fluttered and peacefully flew, and ferried the snails to the ball. Beginning. From every direction, guests are all crowding to join in the fun. Was ever there seen such a varied collection of beautiful creatures? The ball has begun. First the damselflies ballet, so nimble on tiptoe, with glittering wings, and so famous, these four, they can kick in a can-can or dance a calypso, and whatever they do always gets an encore. When Rabbit and Fox put on different faces, you can't be quite certain whichever they are, but soon all the guests will be showing their paces to the loud hurdy-gurdy and Froggy's guitar. They'll see Aranea and Gossamer prancing over Harlequin Hair with his one-hair band, and Happy-Go-Lucky Grasshopper dancing with lovely winged butterflies hand in hand. With slugs, mice, squirrels, and all sorts of creatures, ants, moths, and earwigs, the place will be packed. Some will say, whose are those faces and features? And all will be happy as act follows act. Each one will feel that this great ball is bringing the joy of a lifetime. And all are agreed with... As night turns to dimness and draws back its curtain, stars, those bright sequins, now all disappear. As dimness grows radiant, dawn makes it certain that butterfly weather, quite perfect, is here. Thundery cumulus masses are drifting very far off. Overhead, very high, cirrus clouds spread their pink feathers, then lifting, dissolve and are lost in the turquoise blue sky. Up comes the sun, and the very long shadows grow shorter. His light is like amber, the glow where gray mists have melted away from the meadows starts dewdrops all sparkling like jewels below. Creatures that fly or that creep, hop or run, now wake all at once at a loud trumpet call to tell them this greatest of days has begun, the day of the feast and the butterfly ball. At the sound of the trumpet, the dozens invited now jump out of bed, squealing, "This is the day! Oh, goody, the ball! Aren't you really madly excited? Get up and get ready. Let's be on our way." Beginning. From every direction, guests are all crowding to join in the fun. Was ever there seen such a varied collection of beautiful creatures? The ball has begun. First the damselfly's ballet, so nimble on tiptoe, with glittering wings, and so famous, these four, they can kick in a can-can or dance a calypso, and whatever they do always gets an encore.
The feeling's good. I know that I should be somewhere elsewhere other than here. Together again.
To the ball. We'll put on an airlift. I think it's our duty and ferry them there, said the Camberwell beauty. We'll fly through the sky in this festival weather, a seven in hand, all harnessed together, and we can bring them to the ball. So swallowtail, orange tip, peacock, and brimstone, purple emperor, little chalk blue, brighter than flags of the quarreling nations, happily fluttered and peacefully flew and ferried the snails to the ball. Thank you. had set out a wooing, but having sung and having played and found that there was nothing doing, comfortably down he laid both himself and his guitar, where the spotted agarics are. On the pillow dreaming, he saw uprising, circling sea persons known to you. Out a wooing, but having sung and having played and found that there was nothing doing, comfortably down he laid both himself and his guitar, where the spotted agarics are. On the pillow dreaming, he saw uprising, circling sea persons known to you.
you.
Could those creatures that slither and crawl ever have got to the butterfly ball? All had been asked and wanted to go, but snails are so sluggish and slugs are so slow.